Want to know more about drawing with color pencils? Meet local artist Susan Idlet. In this studio visit, Susan will tell us about her artwork, why she makes illustrations, and how she creates them.
Hi, my name is Susan Idlet, and I'm an artist living in South Fayetteville. I've only been an artist for about 4 years since my retirement, and I joined Phoenix Art Gallery in Fayetteville on the Square, and I've been exhibiting in several other venues throughout Northwest Arkansas. I work pretty much exclusively with colored pencils. My drawings are just saturated with color, and while some of it's realistic, there's some very unexpected twists to my work. Someone once called my art surreal folk art, and I think that's true. A lot of my work really is surreal. For example, I'll put people in an ant farm watched over by giant ants, or a giant cat invading a city. A lot of my best ideas, for some reason, come to me when I'm in the shower. A lot of times it's just words. I am a big word person. Puns, funny things, things that have an odd juxtaposition, those things do it for me. Or the title of a song, like that Joni Mitchell song, You Turn Me On, I'm a Radio. And of course my natural surroundings, other people's work, photographs, all those things come into play when I'm thinking of what to draw next. I decided to become an artist when I was just a little girl. We lived in Baltimore in a three-story row house, just a few blocks from the Maryland Institute of Art. And my mother would rent the third floor to art students. They were fascinating to me, and I really got inspired by what they were doing. Sometimes these students that we rented to would trade actual art in exchange for rent. I still have some of their pieces hanging in my house today. I knew at that very young age that I wanted to be an artist. I thought that I would grow up, I would dress all in black, I would live in a garret or a fifth floor walk-up in Greenwich Village, and I would drink a lot of coffee and just do my art. That was my little six-year-old vision for my future. Now, when I became 15 years old, one of my art teachers made a really disparaging remark about my work, and that made me stop. I just stopped doing art altogether. I became a full-blown hippie. I engaged in all kinds of activities to do with social justice. I was into music. I totally left my art behind. My adulthood was all about working in the field of marketing and advertising, and I was a very busy single mother, not an artist, doing just anything but. And then one day I stumbled on those meditative adult coloring books. I love doing those books, and I did nothing but for about 6 months until they bored me. And then the artist inside me woke up. And now I spend my days happily at my table coloring while I'm listening to soundtracks of my pencil sharpener and 70s rock and roll and some books on tape. It's a great way to spend the day and perfectly timed with my retirement. I first assemble my picture on the computer using Photoshop. I use my own photos and or images I pull off the internet. I always try to get permission from the original photographer to use their work before incorporating it into my own piece. I print the image, tape it on top of thick 100-pound smooth paper. Then using a sharp pencil, I loosely outline the image, applying pressure that will then form faint grooves on the paper beneath. These grooves can be seen with an angled light, and I lightly pencil them in. This step helps me make sure that the proportions are correct. And then I just constantly refer to the original image and basically draw what I see. Sometimes it's a good idea to turn your piece upside down to make sure you're not drawing what you think should be there. I like to lay down the highlights first using a soft white pencil. Sometimes, if I don't find the exact color I need, the softness of the pencils help me combine colors to get just that right tone. You should know that colored pencils are very hard to erase, and you can't really draw on top of something the way you can paint over places you want to change. You know, I think everyone has the ability to create art, whether it's with colored pencils or any other medium that excites you. The key is to start. It could be just free-flowing abstracts or Maybe you're drawing a favorite photograph, or maybe you're just trying to communicate an idea or a feeling. The key is just to start. This is the very first non-coloring book piece I did, a lucky cat that I embellished with shapes and patterns, even words. I just let my imagination run wild. So early on, I read this book, Art and Fear, and that's exactly what I was feeling. Fear. So I decided to draw it. That's my hand on the table with pencils and a blank page ahead of me, and that communicated the fear that I was feeling. I totally recommend this book if you're unsure of yourself or you're just looking for some motivation. I hope you'll look at other artists' work and identify the characteristics of their art that really speak to you. And because I just love color, some of the artists that really speak to me are David Hockney, Matisse, and Frida Kahlo, to name a few. Thank you for allowing me to share my art and my process with you. I hope that you can find the same joy and all-consuming passion that I have found. It's the best thing ever to tap into your creative self, and just do it.
Thanks for joining us. Be sure to watch the other videos on this page to learn how to make your own art with food as a theme, and continue creating together.